Let the people decide! Let the people decide!
Amid an increasingly contentious election, a Supreme Court vacancy, with the confirmation battle of the president's nominee potentially having down-ballot implications.
I think both sides are trying to use this issue to energize their base.
While all eyes are on the presidential race, also at stake, 35 seats in the Senate, with Democrats hoping to turn at least 3 seats blue this November. Races are growing increasingly competitive, with Democrats hoping to pick up seats in Montana, Iowa, and North Carolina. And in South Carolina, Democratic candidate Jaime Harrison is raising a record amount of campaign cash in hopes of unseating incumbent Lindsey Graham.
I'm very proud of the campaign that we're running. It's a very big contrast with that of Lindsey Graham, who's focused on playing Washington political games.
Graham is currently leading Harrison narrowly in the polls, with the Cook Political Report calling the seat a toss-up, and confirmation hearings could give the senator a boost heading into Election Day.
Lindsey Graham, who chairs the Senate Judiciary Committee, will be front and center. And it's important to remember, South Carolina, even though that race is close, South Carolina is a conservative state.
However, some experts say the potential for the Supreme Court hearings to actually sway voters' ballots may be unlikely this close to the election. But with Joe Biden leading in national polls by double digits, political experts caution a down-ballot bump for Democrats could be a game-changer.
The difference between a Senate run by the Democrats and a Senate run by the Republicans is what's going to matter for at least the next 2 years in American politics. It's really where attention ought to be focused.